Hey, Seth David here. Welcome to Notes from Nerds Desktop. These are very short tips and tricks and tutorials just based on things I read or think about that I think might help boost your productivity. So this one, we're talking about using Google Calendar to track your receipts. I read this tip, I forget, in an article somewhere, and I thought it was pretty clever. So of course I know that there are many sophisticated apps that will let you track your bills and receipts, and you can forward them in, or they can fetch them, and then you have to feed authentication codes, and then it doesn't work, whatever. Let's say you just want to keep it simple, and you don't want to pay for an app, and you just want something that's already there at your fingertips that you can use to a very good effect for tracking your receipts. I thought this was very clever. I want to say I read it on like Forbes or Inc.com or something like that. Here's what it is. They suggested using Google Calendar to track your receipts. So here's how it might work. First of all, instead of muddying up your main calendar with it, Google Calendar makes it very easy, of course, to add a new calendar, right? So just so I don't have to add a whole new calendar for this, I'm just going to pick on, let's call it this event or conference calendar, right? So I'm going to turn off the other calendar, so I'm only looking at this one. And let's just say that today I got back and I just renewed my motor vehicle registration, right? So I can call this DMV renewal, right? And then I'm going to go to more options, and I'm going to attach a file. I just love this. So it's going to scan my Google Drive account for recent files and that sort of thing, but I can go straight here to upload, and then I can drag it from my other screen. Right? I've got my trusty ScanSnap here to my right, so it's very quick and easy to scan things, and then I'll click upload. We probably do want to rename it so that, because I'm guessing we're going to want to use search for this. And as you can see, this is like a very generic kind of name. It's not even complete. So let's cancel that. Let's rename it with something sort of intelligent, right? So what do we want to call this? First, I'll just write it out right here. I'm looking at the bill on my other screen. We'll call this DMV renewal. And we'll put in the date. It's actually 2020. 0508. The amount was $319 for the renewal. Anything else? I can put the car make and model, right? Make, model, whatever I want to do, I can put in the name of the PDF. So I'm going to copy that and I'll close the file so I can rename it in Windows. Rename. And now I'm going to attach it and leave the text there as well, right? Because this way, for sure, it's searchable. And then I'll choose upload and save. Okay, now let's test my search capabilities. If I go DMV, boom, it's going to come right up. Just out of curiosity, let's see if it can find my $319. It doesn't. Actually, if I do just 319, because I didn't put the pennies in there, I just put, notice it does find this. Right, and now I've got the item right there. It found the 319. So if you're like me, then what I want to do is I want to expand on that. Because first of all, I'm kind of curious to test if it's finding it based on this or based on what's in the file name. Right, so let's see if now, because when I originally searched for 319 with the pennies, it didn't come up. All right, let's go back to my regular old calendar. I want to get out of search. I hate when it does that. There it is. That's getting out of search. Back to search. All right, 319.00. And it doesn't find it that way. Again, if I put just 319, now it doesn't find it at all, which is kind of interesting. Let's go back to today. Come into here. So it wasn't finding it that way. One sure way is to put this whole thing up here. Right? Now I guarantee you I can put anything from there into this appointment and find it. And sure enough, then it finds it. So there you have it. Use Google Calendar to track copies of receipts. The main point of this is, you know, having a system where it's going to be easy to find the stuff later on when you're looking for it. And again, if you don't want to deal with any fancy apps or anything like that, this is a great way to do it. So do it. If you have any questions, concerns, comments, feedback, or anything along those lines, you know where to find me. As always, I hope you learned something here, had some fun along the way. I hope you're having an absolutely fantastic day, and I look forward to seeing you on the web.